After exerting a lot of blood, sweat, and beers, Eric Church is experiencing not one, but two career milestones. His latest album, Chief, has just gone platinum, selling over 1 million copies, while the project's third single, Springsteen, has now become his second number one hit. Like a soundtrack to a July Saturday. Church threw a party in Nashville featuring the double celebration, and of course, he did have a drink in his hand from his brand new bottle of limited edition Jack Daniel's whiskey.
There are moments, I think, in your life when you just want to kind of pause and go, is this my life? And this is one of them. I mean, it's been an unreal year, from Chief coming out to Springsteen, drinking my hand before that. It's about the music, and it wasn't anything that was fabricated. It was that this is something that we all believed in. I love you all, and thanks for the whiskey, most of all.
After holding on for 2 weeks at the top spot, you can bet you'll hear Springsteen out on the road as Church extends his Blood, Sweat, and Beers tour into the fall. Hit up headlinecountry.net for a complete list of dates. Toby Keith has been given the all clear to return to performing after a health scare. Toby underwent outpatient surgery to remove his gallbladder. Just days after the procedure, Toby resumed his Live and Overdrive tour at WeFest in Detroit Lakes, Minnesota, just in time to push his brand new single, another one about beer, I Love Girls Who Drink Beer. Hey, I find what I want in a honky-tonk.
I like girls. And it's real thoughtful, you know, philosophical, life-changing song.
It's the first song from a new album due out this fall.
I gave them a serious song. They just didn't pick it.
New music is great. You know, it just really, it is. And I love playing new music. I don't do a lot of it in my show because I've always felt like if I'm in the audience and I got my favorite singer or my favorite group, my artist, whatever, I want to come hear the songs that I've lived with. I want to hear it every day. You know, that I've lived with, you know, and whenever anybody does an unknown song, you know, and they're satisfying themselves up there.
Yeah. We've seen it happen.
I've done it. I didn't like the way it was. I said, I'm never doing that again.
Well, there's no need for Kenny Chesney to worry about his newest single, Come Over, crashing and burning during one of his sold-out stadium shows. In just 11 weeks, the song has just earned the superstar his 24th number one. Chesney's Brothers of the Sun tour with Tim McGraw is currently on the road through August. Come over, come over, come over, come over, come over. It's all about tonight. After hitting the road hard all year long, Blake Shelton is finally getting the chance to dive into one of his secret guilty pleasures, Christmas.
Man, I think I'm more excited about my Christmas album than I have been any of my regular studio albums. I mean, I love Christmas music. In fact, I drive Miranda crazy because I listen to it in springtime, you know. So I just wanted to do pretty much a classic Christmas album. I mean, there's three or four things on there that are definitely country with fiddle and steel on them, but mostly it's big orchestra stuff. Three or four original songs on there, and then the rest of them are all classics, or what I consider to be classics.
Blake Claus coming up. What's the title of the record?
It's called Cheers, It's Christmas, believe it or not.
Very fitting.
Miranda actually named my Christmas album. I told her, you know, because there's a ton of duets and special guests and stuff on the album, and I said, man, I wish she would make it, you know, something that involves people somehow. Sure. And she came up with that, and I loved it.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Look for the Christmas Project in stores October 2nd, just in time for the holidays. Yeah.